Hello everybody, so in this session we will start our second transmission line, that is the medium transmission line. So as you know, transmission lines are classified into three categories based on the physical line length and the frequency. So those are the short transmission line, medium transmission line and long transmission line. Now if you take the power frequency, that is 50 hertz or 60 hertz, then if the line length, if it is greater than 80 km and less than 250 km, then that particular transmission line is classified as a medium transmission line. In some cases, this 250 km is taken as 300 km, but roughly in most of the case we take line length to be less than 250 km and greater than 80 km. Okay, so this is valid if your system frequency is at power frequency, that is 50 hertz or 60 hertz. Okay, but in general, if frequency is anything, then if product of length into frequency, if it is less than 12,500 kilometer hertz and greater than 4,000 kilometer hertz, then that particular transmission line will be classified as a medium transmission line. Okay. Now, how we have arrived of this particular number? Now, what we can do? We can take frequency as 50 hertz. So, this 50 hertz into 80 kilometer, so it will be 4,000 kilometer hertz. Okay. So, if length into frequency is greater than 4,000 kilometer hertz. And if it is less than, again 50 into 250, that is 12,500 km hertz, then that particular transmission line will be classified as a medium transmission line. For example, if your system frequency is say 25 hertz and if your line length is say 400 km, then also your line will be classified as a medium transmission line, because in that case product of length into frequency will be 10,000 km hertz. Okay, so we have to consider both the frequency as well as line length, okay, to judge whether the line is short line, medium line or long line. Okay, now today our focus will be on the medium transmission line. Now there are three ways by which we can analyze the medium transmission line. Now what do you mean by analysis of medium transmission line? Now based on the receiving end parameter, we need to determine the various quantities like voltage regulation, efficiency, line losses, sending end voltage, sending end power factor, sending end current. To determine all this is nothing but the analysis of transmission line. So there are three ways by which we can do the analysis of medium transmission line. First is the end condenser method, second is the nominal T method, third is the nominal pi method. Okay, now today we will see the first method, that is end condenser method. Okay, so I will give the title as end condenser method. So how we can represent the transmission line by using end condenser method? So if I draw the circuit diagram, then it will look like this. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram of medium transmission line using end condenser method. So as you can see here, this is a per phase diagram. So we are drawing always a per phase system. So this is your sending end voltage Vs, sending end current Is, receiving end current Ir. This is your load. So voltage across load is Vr. So this is the capacitor, which is nothing but the condenser. Condenser means capacitor, which is located at the receiving end. Therefore, this method is known as the end condenser method. Okay. So this is your resistance and this is your reactance. So together it will have an impedance of Z. Clear? Now voltage across the capacitor will be same as the voltage across the receiving end. That is, voltage across capacitor will be Vr. Okay. Now current flowing through the capacitor, it is Ic. Current flowing through the capacitor is a Ic. Okay. So this particular method is known as a end condenser method. Now we have to obtain the expressions for Vs, Is, similarly the other parameters like voltage regulation, efficiency and other thing. Okay, so for that, what we need to do, we need to draw the phasor diagram. Okay, so how to draw the phasor diagram? Okay, so for drawing the phasor diagram, always we should take some reference. Okay, so here we will take a reference as a receiving end voltage Vr. Okay, before that, remember this is a per phase diagram. So Vs will be per phase, or the phase sending end phase voltage. Vr will be sending end receiving end phase voltage. Is will be sending end phase current. Ir will be receiving end phase current. Okay, so all the quantities are पर फेज. आर इज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ पर फेज, दैट इज ऑफ वन कंडक्टर. एक्स इज द रिएक्टेंस ऑफ वन कंडक्टर. सी, रिमेंबर सी इज नॉट, वी आर एक्सटर्नली कैपेसिटेंस इज कनेक्टेड. कैपेसिटेंस विल बी कनेक्टेड इन द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन इटसेल्फ. ओके, सो दैट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ लाइन इटसेल्फ. सो दिस इज अ पर फेज कैपेसिटेंस. ओके, नाउ वी विल ड्रॉ द फेजर डायग्राम. नाउ हाउ टू ड्रॉ फेजर डायग्राम, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू टेक द रेफरेंस. ओके, सो आई विल गिव द टाइटल हियर एज अ फेजर डायग्राम. So first we will take a reference. So reference usually we are taking as a VR. So VR is usually taken as a reference. So that is the common practice. So receiving end per phase voltage VR we are taking as a reference. Okay. So first we will draw a line VR which is along positive x-axis. Okay. So that is a reference convention. Now from VR we can determine the IR. Okay. So from VR means if I assume the power factor as lagging, then if I am taking VR as a reference, then IR I have to indicate in a clockwise direction. Okay, because most of the time current lags the voltage. Practically loads are inductive load. Okay, so if it is a lagging load, so IR we have to indicate in a clockwise direction. So if I indicate the IR, so IR will be somewhere here. Okay, so this is the receiving end current. IR. Okay, so we have indicated VR, IR. Now next we have to obtain IS. Now if you apply KCL at this particular node, what will be IS? IS will be equal to IR plus IC. Okay, so already we have drawn the IR, so we need to determine the or we need to draw the IC. Now where we should indicate IC? Now remember, IC is the current flowing through the capacitor. Okay, and how much is voltage across capacitor? Voltage across capacitor is VR. So therefore IC will lead VR by 90 degree because it is a pure capacitor, ideal capacitor. Okay, so IC leads VR by 90 degree means we have to indicate IC in anti-clockwise direction at an angle of 90 degree. Okay, so if I indicate IC, so your IC will be somewhere here. Okay, so this is your IC and this angle it will be 90 degree. Clear? Because for pure capacitor current leads the voltage by 90 degree. Now we have to add IR and IC, because when we add IR plus IC, then we will get IS. Okay, so we will add IR and IC. So same IC we have to draw here. So this is your IC, same IC. So by triangle law we can add. So IR plus IC, so this will give us the sending end current IS. Okay, so this current we will get, IS is IR plus IC. Okay, so if I join this third side, what we will get is IS, sending end current. Okay, so IR plus IC is IS. Okay, so we have obtained the first unknown parameter, that is sending end current. Next we have to determine the sending end voltage VS. So how to determine VS? If you apply KVL to this loop, VS will be equal to VR plus IS into R plus IS into X. Okay, or VS equal to VR plus IS into Z. So we have to add the voltage drop across resistance and reactance. Okay, now how to indicate the voltage drop across resistance and reactance? Okay, so it is very easy to indicate. So first is the resistance. So we know the basic property that for resistance, voltage drop will be in phase with the current. Okay, so IS into R, so where shall we indicate IS into R? We have to draw a line which is parallel to IS. So draw a line which is parallel to IS. Okay, so this is IS into R. Okay, so this line IS and ISR, they will be in parallel because voltage drop across resistance, that is IS into R, it will be in phase with IS. Clear? Now we have to indicate voltage drop across inductor. Now we know that voltage drop across inductor, it will lead the current flowing through it by 90 degree. Okay, so current flowing through inductor is IS. So leading to this, we have to indicate voltage drop across inductor. So we have to go in anti-clockwise direction by 90 degree. Okay, so in this direction we have to go 90 degree. Okay, or in other terms, we should indicate here itself because we have to add into VR this particular drop. Okay, so I will indicate this. So this is our voltage drop across reactance, inductive reactance, IS into X. Okay, and this angle will be how much? It will be 90 degree. Okay, so this is VR, this is IS into R, and this is IS into X. Okay, now if I apply KVL to this particular loop, what will be Vs? Vs will be equal to Vr plus Isr plus Is into x. Okay, so meaning is that I have to join this particular side to obtain the result. Okay, so that is the basic law of determining the resultant of addition of vectors. Okay, so this will be your sending end phase voltage Vs. Clear? So this will be your angle phi s. I am indicating by red color phi s, and angle between Vr and Ir, that will be phi r. Okay, so I will indicate this. So this angle, it is phi r. So phi r is the receiving end phase voltage and phi s is the sending end phase voltage. Okay, so this is the phasor diagram. So first step, we have indicated Vr. Practically currents are lagging, loads are in inductive load, so IR, it will be in clockwise direction. Next, we have to obtain IS. So by applying KCL, IS is IR plus IC. So draw a line which is perpendicular to VR. Okay, so that is IC. So IR plus IC, that will be IS by triangle law. Now we have to add the voltage drop due to sending end current. So ISR, that will be voltage drop in resistance. ISX will be the voltage drop in the reactance. So if you add, we will get the Vs. Okay, now one important thing here, so always in transmission line, reactance is very large as compared to resistance. Okay, so if you see the ratio of X by R, it is very large. Okay, it is usually more than 5 or more than 10 in some cases. So therefore, length of ISX is shown more than length of IS. Okay, that is the thing. So angle between Vs and IS is phi S. Okay, now we have to write the equation based on this particular circuit diagram and the phasor diagram. So how to write the equations? Okay, so we will follow the same thing that is used to draw the phasor diagram. So first thing what we have done, so we have taken Vr as a reference. Okay, so first term you can write as Vr bar equal to Vr at an angle of 0 degree. Okay, so that is the first thing we have done. We have drawn the phasor Vr. The next, we have obtained the current. Okay, so current, as you know, Ir, it will be magnitude Ir at an angle of minus phi r. Okay, so at an angle of minus phi r. Okay, so why it is minus phi r? Because practically loads are inductive, so therefore it will be minus. Clear? Let us call this as equation number 2. So after Vr and Ir, what is the next thing that we did here? So after Vr and Ir, we have obtained the IC, and where IC is shown, IC is shown at an angle 90 degree with respect to Vr. So how we can write equation of IC? So IC by Ohm's law, it will be equal to Vr divided by impedance of capacitor. And what is impedance of pure capacitor? It is minus j Xc. Okay, impedance of pure capacitor is minus j Xc. So that is equal to Vr divided by minus j. And what is Xc? Xc is nothing but 1 over omega c. So minus j by omega c. Okay, so that is nothing but 1 upon minus j is plus j, and this omega c will go in numerator. So it will be j omega c Vr. So IC will be equal to j omega c Vr, or in terms of frequency, we can write IC as j 2 pi f c Vr. J 2 pi f c Vr. Okay, so that will be equation of capacitor current that will flow through the capacitor. Okay, this bar indicate that all the quantities are phasor quantities or AC quantities. Okay, so we have obtained the IC. What next thing we have done after drawing the IC? So after drawing the IC, we have obtained the IS by applying KCL. Okay, so by applying KCL, we will get sending end current IS. By applying KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, IS, it will be equal to IR plus IC. Okay, equation number 4. So already IR we have obtained in equation number 2, IC is obtained in equation number 3. So we have got IS. Now what next thing we have done after calculating IS? After IS, what we have done, we have determined Vs by applying KVL to this particular loop. So Vs is Vr plus ISR plus IS into X. Okay, so by applying KVL to the loop, so by applying KVL, so Vs, it will be equal to VR plus IS into Z. What is Z? Z is the series impedance of line. Okay, so Z is nothing but what? R plus JX. Okay, because it is a RL line, RL circuit. If you see this particular transmission line, it consists of resistance and reactance. Okay, so impedance will be R plus JX. Okay, so if I put this value here, so I will get VS. So VS equal to VR plus IS into R plus JX. So that is VS equal to VR plus IS into R plus J times IS into X. Okay, so this is say equation number 6 and this is equation number 5. Okay, so what we obtained? We obtained the sending end per phase voltage. We also obtained the sending end per phase current. Angle between this, because when we solve practically, VS will be at some angle, IS will be some at some angle. So if you subtract the angle of VS minus angle of IS, then you will get phi S. And if you take cos, you will get the sending end power factor. Okay. Now next thing, what is practically required is the efficiency. So how we can obtain the transmission efficiency? Okay. So transmission efficiency, it is denoted by the symbol eta. As you know, it is the ratio of receiving end power. If I take say 3 phase, so PR 3 phase divided by the sending end power, that is PS 3 phase. Okay, sorry, this should be 3 phase. Okay, if you take PR single phase, we have to divide by PS single phase. Okay, so this is equal to, now what will be PR 3 phase? It will be nothing but 3 into V magnitude VR phase into IR into cos phi R divided by 3 into VS phase voltage into IS phase current into cos phi S. So this 3 and 3 will get cancelled. So what you will get as VR phase voltage into IR into cos phi R divided by VS phase voltage into IS into cos phi S. Okay, now see, most of the time practically our system is the star connected, so therefore IR phase and IR line both will be same. So I am not writing phase or line here. Okay, so this is the expression of efficiency. Okay, so if you want in percentage, what you need to do, you need to multiply by 100. Okay, so that will be percentage efficiency. Okay, now there is another way to determine the percentage efficiency. So what is the other way? So other way, you can consider efficiency as receiving end 3 phase power PR 3 phase divided by receiving end 3 phase power plus total power loss. Total power loss. Okay. And how to determine power loss? Now see this, where power loss will take place. In this system, power loss is going to take place only in resistance. Okay. So how much power loss will be there? IS square into R. For one phase, so total power loss means we have to multiply by 3. So it will be 3 into IS square into R. That will be the total power loss. Okay. So if I write this, so this will be equal to 3 times VR phase IR cos phi R divided by 3 into VR phase IR cos phi R plus 3 times magnitude IS square into R. Okay, so output power divided by output power plus losses, because when you add output power plus losses, basically what you will get, you will get the input power. Okay, so by this expression we can determine the efficiency. Now next thing, that is the voltage regulation. Okay, now approximately voltage regulation we can determine by this formula, that is VS minus VR divided by VR. Okay, but this will not give us the exact voltage regulation. Okay, this is the approximate relation. This expression is exactly valid for short line, but for medium and long line this will not give us the exact relation. So what will be exact relation? Exact relation will be VR no load minus VR full load divided by VR full load. Okay, magnitude. okay, and you have to multiply by 100 if you want it in percentage, okay, if this is in percentage, okay. Now this expression will give you the exact voltage regulation, okay. Now VR no load, if you want to determine, it is basically VS upon capital A, where A is the ABCD parameter, okay. Out of ABCD parameter we have to take A here. So VR no load is VS upon A minus VR by VR, okay. So how to determine A, that we will cover in the upcoming sessions, but for time being you remember this expression, voltage regulation is VR no load minus VR full load divided by VR full load. VR no load is nothing but VS upon capital A. So how to determine A, that we will cover in the upcoming sessions, okay. So here we have determined voltage regulation, we have determined the efficiency, we have determined sending end voltage, we have determined sending end current as well as sending end power factor, okay. So we have used here the method which is known as the end condenser method or the end capacitor method. So capacitor is assumed to be connected at the receiving end, therefore it is known as the end condenser method. So we have drawn the circuit diagram, phasor diagram, and we have written all the equations to determine the various sending end parameters and the various line parameters like efficiency, voltage regulation, sending end voltage, sending end current and sending end power factor, okay. So practically most of the time we don't use end condenser method because whatever results we are getting by this method, these are not very accurate, okay. Practically mostly we use the nominal pi method, okay. But if you want to use end condenser method, so how to use that method, that is explained in this particular session, okay. So I hope you understood how to apply end condenser method for the analysis, okay. Thank you.